Hey guys, Tech Tim here. So I'm going through the process of reconnecting my multiple or a portion of my multiple ECHO/ALEXA devices to my new Wi-Fi network. And it's been a little painful, I'm not gonna lie. So I'm basically going through one by one. I thought initially I could create a long form video and just do them all at once, but it has not been that easy. But I think I kind of have it down to a science now, where basically what you wanna do is, if your devices fall off the network and or you just happen to get this message in your ALEXA app, you want to just follow what it says on screen to a T. So basically, don't hit the action button. Don't do anything that doesn't tell you to do. Just follow it to a T, and you might have some luck with just getting these things back online. So I've gotten several of them online now. So we have a bunch of Echo shows that have already connected. My Echo Studios are connected up. My actual Echo is connected up. At least one Echo Dot, but I have some other Echo Dots that is asking me to connect. And oh yeah, the message disappears after a little bit, and it asks you to move on to the next one, which is somewhat annoying. So, and now it's asking about this one. So this is my Echo Dot fourth gen with clock, and the clock is there you go. So you can see after it gets connected, it's going to display a clock instead of the volume controls there. But so basically what we want to do is we want to follow the instructions to the letter. So Echo Dot, bring your phone close to the device and tap continue. So we're close enough, so I'm going to tap continue. And so there is. Now it's going to search for Wi-Fi. And my understanding is, if you have a saved Wi-Fi network, it will connect up to that. This has not gone well. I do have a saved Wi-Fi network. Sometimes it connects, sometimes it doesn't. But let's just see what happens here. And this guy here is the one that's giving me the most trouble. So maybe this will help you as well. So I'm just going to take this guy off of mute now. And that's really neither here nor there. I could have left it on mute. But I'm going to select my 2.4 gigahertz network, because it did not find it automatically to connect up to. And the reason that you want to select 2.4 gigahertz, or I do, is because all my other ALEXA devices are on that same network. And so I have a 5 gigahertz network that presumably you would think, oh, 5 gigahertz is stronger than 2.4. So I've been told by Verizon and also Xfinity and others that actually the 2.4 gigahertz is the way you want to go for your ALEXA devices, at least for now, if you have a smaller crib like I do. I have roughly, 575 square feet, I think, something like that. But, and then so I'm going to pick my 2.4 gigahertz network, which is Tatooine. And I know all you guys know about Tatooine, right? So now it's going to see.
Your Echo is ready.
And there we go. So we're connected. Clock automatically comes online, which is cool. And so the trick is, it did not remember it, which I was expecting it to. So I just had to select it in the app. But in terms of connecting, I didn't have to hit the action button. I just had to follow what the instructions were in the app. In the past, you'd have to hit this round action button on the top and then go back and forth between the device and the app. But now they've sort of solved all of that, and the whole process is just much easier. So now I can say, I think this one is called Computer. Are you there? And okay. Why don't we say Computer? What time is it? Oh, this one is also computer.
The time is 5:01 p.m.
And so there you go. So we have this one back online. And what I'll do next is I will move on to the next one. So we're going to say done. And I
nice
think
work.
There we
I
go.
I have a few top
so
things
now she's
going to
go through her little spiel of things to try.
Let's get started.
And then, but I more importantly than that, I'm going to turn her down, because we know this one's live, and that's just a little bit of marketing things she wants you to try and configure and try out and so forth. But now, as you can see in the app, it's asking me about my next device that I need to connect up, and that's this guy. So I'll do that. So this is Echo Dot fifth gen. I'll do a separate video of that next. But for now, we got the fourth gen with clock back online, which was sort of the objective here. So this guy's all set, and now I will go through the app and I'll start to configure that one next. So anyway, hope this video helped, and hope you have an Echo Dot fourth gen with clock. Able to get it back on your Wi-Fi network successfully. And if you did, if you wouldn't mind subscribing, I do all sorts of videos about ALEXA and Echo devices and so forth. So hope to see you in the next one. Cheers.